Hello guys, good morning. I am Santosh Singh and today we are going to see architecture of Apache Sqoop. So let's see these things and welcome to my channel. So in Sqoop architecture, as we are seeing this image, this picture, and in this diagram we are seeing that here is a RDBMS, and this RDBMS might be any RDBMS. It might be SAP HANA, it might be DB2, it might be PostgreSQL, it might be MySQL, it might be Oracle, IBM NetAja, it might be any RDBMS. And suppose that this RDBMS have 1 TB of data. We have 1 TB of data on this RDBMS. This might be sales data, or this might be any medical data. It may be any data. So if we need to process this 1 TB of data, 1 TB means 1024 GB of data, then it is not easy task to processing huge amount of data on RDBMS is not a easy task. So if we need to process this huge amount of data, then it will take so much effort and time as well. So what we do, we transfer this 1 TB of data on HDFS, and after transferring this 1 TB of data on HDFS, based on some condition we process this data, and suppose that after processing output will be 25 GB, and again we transfer this output to RDBMS, and we can see the report of 25 GB data on RDBMS. So like this way we can process this huge amount of data on HDFS, and after processing we again transfer this data to RDBMS. And how we can transfer this data from RDBMS to HDFS and from HDFS to RDBMS, we can do these things by Sqoop. We can transfer this data by using Sqoop. When we are transferring data from RDBMS to HDFS, then it is called import. And when we transfer data from HDFS to RDBMS, then it is called export. So we can import data from RDBMS to HDFS, and we can export data from HDFS to RDBMS. SQL work is only exporting and importing data from one place to another place. One place means from RDBMS to HDFS and from HDFS to RDBMS, and nothing else. We will see these term very frequently in Hadoop, OLAP and OLTP. OLAP means online analytical processing, and OLTP means online transactional processing. And we will see this is the very frequently used term in Hadoop. And as we know that RDBMS perform both OLAP and OLTP. So now let's see the next things. As we have seen that by using Sqoop, we can transfer data from RDBMS to HDFS. And in this diagram, we are seeing that by using Sqoop, we can transfer data from RDBMS to HIVE, and we can do same things from RDBMS to HBASE as well. So Sqoop can transfer data from RDBMS to HDFS, and from HDFS to RDBMS, and from RDBMS to HIVE, and from HIVE to RDBMS, and again same things from RDBMS to HBASE, and from HBASE to RDBMS. And you are thinking that what is the HIVE? HIVE is a SQL query language of Hadoop, and HBASE is the NoSQL database of Hadoop. We will see that what is the HIVE and what is the HBASE. We are saying that Sqoop can transfer data from any of these platform. Means Sqoop can transfer data on HDFS, it can transfer data on Hive, and it can transfer data on HBASE as well. Let's see the next things. By using Sqoop, we can transfer data from RDBMS to HDFS, and we can transfer data from HDFS to RDBMS, and we can transfer data from RDBMS to Hive, and from Hive to RDBMS, and we can transfer data from RDBMS to HBASE, and the reverse is also, we can transfer data from HBASE to RDBMS. Sqoop used to import data from external RDBMS source to HDFS or Hive or HBASE. Yes, Sqoop can import or export data from HBASE or Hive or HDFS. Any of these platform, Sqoop can transfer data. So in Hadoop, a row of table is called record. A row of a table is treated as a record. Records are stored as text data in text file or as binary data in Avro or in sequence file. This is the file type. We'll see that what is the Avro file and what is the sequence file in Hadoop. We can store data either in text file or in Avro file or in sequence file. And it can use to export data from HDFS or Hive or HBASE or any external RDBMS, as we see that by using Sqoop, we can import or we can export data from RDBMS to HDFS or from RDBMS to Hive or from RDBMS to HBASE and vice versa also. So like this way, we see the architecture of Sqoop, that how Sqoop works. We see this diagram and we see this diagram, and I try to elaborate the architecture by using this diagram. So now let's see the next things, question and answer. First question, does Apache Sqoop have a default database? Answer is yes. MySQL is the default database of Apache Sqoop. And now question second is, difference between this cp command and Sqoop in Hadoop. What is the difference between this cp command and Sqoop in Hadoop? So let's see. As we know that Hadoop disk CP is used for copying large data sets between cluster. You can copy data from one HDFS to another HDFS, but not from local file system. By using Hadoop disk CP command, we can transfer data from one cluster to another cluster like this way. Hadoop space disk CP space, this might be one HDFS place and this might be another HDFS place, but we can transfer the huge amount of data from this place to this place. And now let's see what Sqoop do. In Sqoop, as we see that Sqoop is used for import data from RDBMS such as MySQL or Oracle or mainframe or any RDBMS database to HDFS, and it is also used to export data from HDFS to RDBMS. So like this way, this is the difference between Hadoop disk CP command and Sqoop. Both is used for transferring data from one place to another place, but dist cp command is used to transferring data from one cluster to another cluster on HDFS, but Sqoop is used to transferring data from RDBMS to HDFS and from HDFS to RDBMS. So guys, this is all about the architecture of Sqoop, and if you have any question, then you can share. I will try to answer those things. Thanks for watching, and please subscribe my channels, guys. Thank you so much.